Hello there, and thank you so much for joining us for this special edition of this special interview here on the news. My name is Viola Kusasia, and today we are joined by Paul Busharizi, that is a veteran, a seasoned business writer and editor here with The New Vision. We shall be looking at some of the issues, not necessarily issues, but some of the stories that are trending in the business world and those that came up and were of concern to Ugandans. So let's start off with KCCA. So Paul, thank you very much for joining us. And our first question is on the KCCA. They have moved to start, you know, filling the potholes around the city, and Ugandans were of course noticing, and they asked, why do you fill potholes instead of creating new roads, you know? And the ED was quick to answer and say that we're given money to maintain roads, but that's separate from money that is supposed to be making new roads. And I had her mention that they received 10 billion so far for reconstruction, where they're supposed to be receiving something like, you know, 26 billion per year for reconstruction, and 1 trillion is in the works for 69 kilometers of road. So what do you make of all of this, and how easily can you explain to Ugandans about these kinds of allocations?
You know, well, so first of all, I mean, in my mind, the figure of $1 million per kilometer is a figure that I have in my mind for construction of roads. And so that's about maybe about 4 billion shillings per kilometer. So the Lord Mayor did his arithmetic, and it showed that for the 1 trillion shillings that would be used for the roads and divided by the number of roads, is going to be about 14 billion per kilometer. And so for the, and even for myself, I was taken aback. How can you have it three times more? But these roads are, one, they're going to be more expanded. Many of the roads are actually expanded. Pavements are going to be built. Covered drainages will be as part of the design. There will be junction points, you know, traffic light points in these places. I think there's provisions for bus parks and markets, and so it's not only just laying tarmac. It's more than just laying tarmac. So,
and Paul, local government leaders were also quick to come out and say that allocations in the budget are never, you know, necessarily favorable for the work they are expected to do for Ugandans in various parts of the country. I saw that 143 million is being given to them since the last budget, that was between 2017 and 2018, where they were given 1.1 billion shillings for road construction. And so that huge cut has been of great impact to them and the services people expect from them. So do you think that is something that we shall recover from, or do you see us going very badly when it comes to budget cuts moving forward?
It's the story of our lives in the last year. In December, we had an interview with Ramadan Gobi, who is the PS of the Finance Ministry and also the Treasury. And, you know, interestingly, URA is meeting its targets on revenue. But the government is not releasing all the funds as per the budget. And Ramadan Gobi's explanation at the time was that they're trying to beat back inflation. So inflation many times is caused by too much money falling to few goods. So one way to slow down inflation or bring it under control is to reduce the amount of money in circulation. One of the biggest creators of money in circulation is the government. So if the government constricts its expenditure, then inflation is handled. So it says, So for the last year, we know no one is really getting their budget. I think there are a handful of places which are getting their budget. Everyone is complaining. They are getting, you know, less than half of what they had budgeted for. So if local governments are complaining about roads, you know, everyone is complaining. The truth is that, you know, inflation is something that can totally mess up the economy. So you want to catch it before it gets out of control. There are questions still. I think we still have questions about that. You know, as you say, the way to actually stimulate this economy now is to have more money in circulation, especially people's businessmen's arrears are paid off, which is actually a big challenge. And, you know, that's kind of not happening. So the problem with history is that we forget that it's such tough measures that brought inflation under control, you know, maybe 30 years ago. But you see, 80% of the population was not around 30 years ago to remember that. But it's just the way it has to be, unfortunately.
You mentioned that that's something we can still work with. However, let's look at the impact of these budget cuts continuously and as the years go, which we see may not really change very soon. How can Ugandans adjust to that, especially people that are in the business community?
In the immediate term, you know, costs have to be cut. There's no way around it. There are things which you think that must, you know, a year ago you thought, I cannot cut this cost, but we're being forced to make those decisions. We're going to cut those costs. And so costs have to be cut. There's just no way around it. But if you're reacting now, you're a bit too late. You should have been setting up your company or your business for this years ago. So looking to the future, you really have to be really, really particular about costs, even in good times. The problem is when good times come, you kind of, your costs kind of spiral out of control. So we've got to be thinking that if there are good times now, okay, if just as there are bad times now, the good times will come. If there are good times now, the bad times will come even inevitably. And we have to keep our eye on the ball, especially on costs. Keep them manageable. Instead of spending, maybe you find a way to invest those savings so that you can create new income streams, so that in times like this, you have a fallback position.
All right. I guess people in the business community will have to just make do, especially you mentioned cutting costs, and I guess that's our take home today, cut the costs. Thank you very much, Paul, for making time for this special interview. And thank you very much, too, for watching. We shall see you next time for this special interview. The take home is cut costs within your business if you're a business person. And the rest of you and I, we can also cut costs on whatever our expenditure is. Thank you so much. We shall see you next time. Back to the news.